Hello, welcome to Drinks with Ron. I'm Ron, and that Delta 8, am I right? It's like those chocodiles. Those chocodiles, Haley. Oh my God, those chocodiles. That's how I feel about them. But you know what else I feel that way about? Colored vinyl. I've described it before as kind of a fetish, for lack of a better term. It's not sexual in nature, but it's not. The Beck's Odelay, I believe when I bought this, was a 20-year anniversary release. Special pressing made specifically for this company. I actually had to join like a record of the month club to be able to get this album. But when they said brown, translucent, marbled vinyl, I was on board, man. This one isn't as good as the Ween's 12 Golden Country Greats. The marbling on that is chef's kiss. But this is pretty good. So I fired it up the other day and I thought, what the hell, let's do it again, because Beck and all of his crazy feedback, my dog hates it. Oh shit, and now here's Ted Jansen. So Ted's probably gonna freak out. But don't worry, he'll get over it. I mean, I can't blame him. The feedback's kind of crazy. And here's a nice little retro piece. How the song starts with a record popping sound. I can't tell when my record's fucking dirty, because this starts like it was put on a platter, and there's actually another break later on this side where it stops, and the only thing that's in the entire song is just record popping. And when that played with mine on top of it, threw me off, because I knew what it was supposed to sound like. But let me digress. I need a beer. And the Rue Beer 2021 edition that I've been drinking so heavily on the last handful of episodes is gone. 5 gallons from June, end of June. So it's been about 6 weeks. I didn't have much help. I can't say that I did. But I've got its sister beer is now on the triumvirate of taps here at Third Generation Brewing. And let's fire it up. It is officially carbonated now. So let's see what she looks like. Maybe I should have gave her a little more carbonation time, but a nice golden color. I added a little extra water this year, and holy shit, like hops floating in there. Yeah, I ran it through a really good screen. I figured I would have got everything out of there. But a little more water, and I monkeyed with the yeast. A couple of different kind, made a special house blend. And, yeah, I think I used a top and a bottom fermenting yeast. Don't know why I've done this. I'm gonna blame the Delta 8. Gummies, $2. Moderna, didn't ask for any of this. Ted Jansen, right on cue. I know, dude, the feedback is... But he's an artist. I mean, you've got a... It's not just noise for noise sake. It's... it's done. Thank you. Thank you for protecting me from the crazy sound. He wasn't down here when I started recording, in fairness. But, yeah, the County K's got a little bit of a different flavor. I haven't liked where it's wound up the last couple of years. So the extra water... Yeast combo, and I didn't lager it. It's not, it'd technically be a Kolsch, but I'd let it sit for 3 months. It didn't get 3 months, and I didn't lower the temp way, way down. So, technically not a Kolsch. I guess it's just a long ferment, but it seemed to really clear it up. There is still that little bit of haze. It's my fault, to be honest. Idiot. I said it up front. My dog hates this album. There's just no accounting for taste. But I poured myself a tiny, tiny glass to get a first taste of it. And we'll be finishing it because I'm not paying the wrath of Todd fine today. It's not happening. I got some stuff to do. The giant log. I don't know. I don't think I've worked it into an episode yet. But I, let's say, am 30% done with cutting it into tiny pieces. It's two big key pieces that are coming off today. And once I get those two off, it's like some weird fucking, I don't know, not a Sudoku, it's like a Mahjong with this fucking tree. So once I get these two pieces off, cubed up, sliced off of there, then where the tree splits into two large, the crotch, then I can access that from both sides. And I've already got lines cut all the way down the sides and a few down the middle. So basically what I'm telling you is these two are the fucking linchpin. It's like fucking mall rats. Some careless, Silent Bob stole the schematic from some careless carpenter. Found this in the middle. He pulled this, biggity bang. Motherfucker, the whole thing comes down. Motherfucker's rubble. That's how I feel this tree's gonna be. I mean, it won't be biggity bang. There's gonna be some work involved. But my 14-inch saw will be able to finish the job in relatively short order once I get these two pieces out. But I've got a tree conundrum in the backyard. Big tree there, big tree there. So when the sun tracks through, there's this gap in the trees where you don't want to be out there working on nothing in the sun. So by the time I finish this beer, I should be into tree one, which will give me one good start. I'll get my two pieces out of there. Then my chainsaw, when it gets hot, it shuts off and you can't get it restarted till it cools back down, which is no problem with my carpal tunnel. I probably shouldn't be squeezing on that trigger so long anyway. So it's always a good time to stop, maybe get a beer, top off your gas. Trick that I was taught, which is very fantastic. Don't fill your gas up all the way, because every time you fill up your gas, fill up your bar and chain oil to the top. Leave your gas a little bit low. So if you do run out of gas, you should still have oil left. That's a thing I never would have thought of. I'm not a big chainsaw guy. I don't, I had to buy one for this tree. It's fucking huge, man. 3.5 feet across, 4 as it starts to branch. The big, I mean, shit. One of the branches is almost 3 feet on its own. So my 14-inch saw, I can't even get through both sides. I was gonna buy a 20-inch to do this tree, but then I thought, this is the only thing I'm going to use it for. So then I get this mental picture of myself out front with the fucking maples, just 20-inch fucking saw picking off a branch this big, just like little light pruning with a giant fucking Texas Chainsaw Massacre thing. Which, by the way, tomorrow, Friday the 13th, I gotta call bullshit. There's no realism to that, because there is no way Jason is getting first pull action every time. There's just none. I want to shoot a thing where, you know, where it's realistic, where Jason's like looking around for fucking the 2-cycle oil because he's got to mix it into a jug, because you can't just dump whatever in there. I mean, there's some work to this fucking chainsaw. They don't just sit there ready to fucking go. It ain't like, or maybe if he was tacking somebody with like a Black & Decker battery power, they go 12-inch fucking nub saw. I don't know. What I'm saying is, more than likely, he's gonna sit there pulling this fucking thing in his big fucking jumpsuit and a mask. So his face is gonna be all sweaty. He's gonna be drenched as he pulls over and over, trying to adjust the choke to get the fucking chainsaw started. Even the chick with fucking one high heel will have made it down to the car that can't start. I mean, they would have had time to get it fucking turned over. He'd be like, oh, I got it going, all right. And, you know, fucking walk down the road and overheats, shuts off. You gotta reprime the fucking thing. They get the car started, drive away. Anyway, what I'm saying, chainsaws don't work like that. So, I've got to stretch mine out. I get about 3 good sessions out of my chainsaw between when I get off work and when the sun goes down. So, I've got to get it started as soon as I can, so it's got time to cool down. After supper, I go out, I hit it again. When that shuts down, come downstairs, have a beer, maybe watch a Rick and Morty, and then the sun should be behind that tree. We go fire it up for the 3rd time. But we're getting there. We're getting there. Slow and steady, mother father. I've got a self-imposed deadline of the end of the month. We should hit that. My brother's coming up. I've got him to bring a wagon. I'm gonna get some dirt. Backyard's gonna be rip-roaring. But I gotta start. It's the first first step of the journey, man. I gotta get the first foot going or it don't happen. That whole body's at rest stuff is true. Great fucking album, man. I don't know. I assume anybody watching my show at least is aware of Beck and probably a fan. If by some odd chance you're not, Odelay. Fucking A, man. In fact, before I shut the episode down, let's bust out the custom artwork for this. The inside from the CV cover. Credits, of course. Awesome. I toyed with hanging this up, but I'm already short on space down here. The donkey makes me very happy. I do like him. Probably can't see this because I'm a shoddy cameraman, man. Fucking mailing it in here, dude. But here's another thing they sent. They had an artist reimagine the cover work because, you know, the fucking totally iconic shaggy dog jumping over a bar, fucking font. I mean, takes me back to high school. It's ingrained in my memory. So they thought, we'll reimagine it. And they gave me this. And I was like, man, did you even listen to the album? I mean, art's subjective, as I told my dog earlier, but man, that just don't give me this. And I thought with the luxury of hindsight to know what the album was, I was hoping for something better. I got a buddy who's into art and has made alternate covers, and they're amazing. Anyway, rambling like an old guy with a beard and a chainsaw who homebrews, because I am that guy. So we get at it, but I don't want to pay a Todd fine, so let me find my clicker, and we'll shut her down. So for Drinks with Ron, I am Ron, signing off.